We are a community, it's diverse on who we are, and that forces our ideas to become better. Because I have to explain my idea to a physicist, to an engineer, and a sociologist. Usually that will be a joke, but in this case, it's actually real life.
We're all rational, compassionate human beings first. And then, oh, and by the way, I come from Beirut. By the way, I come from Macedonia. By the way, I come, it's something that we take to be for granted, that we come from somewhere and we have a unique story to tell. You know, we celebrate identity, but we don't essentialize it.
I've always been fascinated in my, you know, what's the problem I'm solving? What difference does it make?
I just wanted to contribute to space exploration.
What is this transition between an atom and a bulk material?
How do authoritarian regimes and dictatorships come about? How do they sustain themselves? What explains regime durability?
I decided that I would work on helping people get smarter.
You know, where is the action happening, right? MIT's name will come up eventually in one way or another. Walk around the infinite corridor and suddenly you see the person who wrote the textbook or the person who won the Nobel Prize. And so it's not any person in the field, it's the person in the field. I mean, that is also inspiring.
There was this draw to MIT because it was this mecca, really, this place where all of this amazing research was happening.
You have all these Time Life books that were always there in my high school. And there was one specific one on technology or engineering, and it talked about MIT. It was always the thought that MIT is where magic happens. And that was the theme of that book. So that has always stuck in my head.
What has really made me come to appreciate MIT is how global MIT really is. We have a faculty of about 20 in our history department. Each of the major regions of the world is represented in terms of the research that they do, but also where they come from.
I am so inspired every day when I go to work and I talk to our students and colleagues about how technology should be advanced.
People take it for granted. MIT has, you know, world-class engineers and scientists. We also have world-class faculty doing cutting-edge work on international affairs, on economics, society, on culture, on history.
It's long been known that if you want the very best ideas, you have to look everywhere. That's how you're going to have access to a whole range of experiences and therefore perspectives.
One of the great things about MIT is that we emphasize fulfillment. Do something that is meaningful, do something that is important, do something that is for somebody else. We want whatever we have in our brain to be actually used and implemented with our hands, but it's always with a purpose of service.